The White Rock is it is really a white rock, and it's situated off the Pacific coast of Mexico, in the state of Nayarit, and it's a place where many different tides of history converge. It's a place for the Wiradjuri people, who are an indigenous tribe of Mexico. It's a place that they say that the world was born. So it's a place that exists at once in real time and space, and in a mythic time and space. The origin of the book comes through my own story and my own encounter with the Wiradjuri people. And the encounter came about because myself and my husband tried for 7 years to have a child. And he, in the course of his work, became involved with the Wiradjuri people. And they encouraged us to take part in a ceremony to pray for a child. And when our daughter was born, we were told that we had to bring her back to Mexico, and we had to present her to the sacred fire in the village where the shamans live, and also to go to the White Rock to give offerings and to give thanks. So my own personal story became entwined with the story of this place. I've always been fascinated by history. But I'm really interested as a writer in what the past can, how the past speaks to us now. So I feel like whenever I'm revisiting a period of the past, it's always to ask, what does it have to say to us now? It's not just to be there only. It's always between now and then. So these three time periods in 1969, 1907, and 1775, and the characters that I'm exploring, all felt to me that they had a really potent part in this bigger story and bigger question that I wanted to write about, which is, here we are at a point of crisis of Western civilization. How did we get here? Just that question. Just that little question.